Hello everyone, today we are going to start digestion and absorption. And digestion and absorption of what? Then it immediately clicks in our mind, then digestion and absorption of food. Then what food is? It is one of the basic requirements of all living organisms, which provides us energy and also organic molecules for growth and repair of body tissues. And what these organic components are? These components are carbohydrates, fats and proteins, and along with this, vitamins and minerals are also required, but in small quantities. Along with food, we take in water, which plays important role in metabolic processes and prevents dehydration of the body. And the biomacromolecules which we take in cannot be used in original forms. That means they have to be broken down first in our digestive system and by the process of digestion. So you can say the process of conversion of complex food substances to simple and absorbable form is called digestion, which is carried out by two methods. One is mechanical and other is biochemical, and this process is carried out in our digestive system. So this is human digestive tract, which comprises alimentary canal along with digestive glands. If we talk about alimentary canal, then it starts from an anterior opening, which is mouth, and ends posteriorly at anus. And from mouth, next part is it. That means mouth leads to esophagus, which opens into stomach, then into small intestine, then large intestine, then to rectum, and finally to anus. And there, in this diagram, you can see salivary glands, pancreas, liver, which is the largest digestive gland, and other glands are also present. And this is also human digestive tract. And we will discuss all parts one by one in detail. If we talk origin of alimentary canal, then alimentary canal develops from ectoderm and endoderm. From mouth up to hard palate, this part is ectoderm in origin, and next palate to rectum, endodermal in origin, and anal canal to anus, ectodermal in origin. As I told you that digestive system comprises two parts, alimentary canal and digestive glands. So this is anatomy of alimentary canal. Alimentary canal is made up of mouth, buccopharyngeal chamber, esophagus, stomach and intestine. This buccopharyngeal chamber further consists of three parts: oral vestibule, buccal cavity and pharynx. This buccal cavity contains tongue, teeth and palate. And palate is of two types, hard and soft. Pharynx is divided into three parts, naso, oro and laryngopharynx. As the name itself suggests, that naso is related to nasal part, oro to oral cavity and laryngeal to larynx. Stomach also has four parts, that is cardiac, fundus, body, pylorus. Intestine is of two types, small and large, and small consists of three parts, duodenum, jejunum, ileum. And large intestine consists of three parts, cecum, colon, rectum, which opens into anus by the help of anal canal. These digestive glands are salivary, gastric, intestinal, liver and pancreas. Now we will start with first part of our alimentary canal, which is mouth and buccopharyngeal cavity. As you can see that direction of mouth or position of mouth is horizontal and transverse. It is horizontal and transverse slit like aperture and is surrounded by two lips. Upper, this is upper lip and lower lip. And lips are movable due to presence of orbicularis or its muscles. Now two types of glands are present, sebaceous and serous glands. These sebaceous glands are present on outer side of lip and serous glands are present in inner side of lip. Sebaceous glands are also known as oil glands. That means it gives oily secretion to your outer side of lip. And serous glands are modification of mucus glands, which secrete the watery secretion. That means some watery substances are released inside the mouth with the help of these serous glands. and then mouth opens into buccal cavity. What buccal cavity? Then the first part of buccal cavity is buccal vestibule. What buccal vestibule is? This space. That means the space between gums and cheeks where the food is stored temporarily. This part is buccal vestibule. Next is oral cavity. This complete is oral cavity. That and it has a number of teeth, tongue and palate. And it is inner and central part which is surrounded by upper and lower jaw. And it is lined by non-keratinized squamous epithelium. Upper jaw is fixed and lower jaw is movable. And the roof of this oral cavity is known as palate. Now palate is differentiated into two parts. Just perform this exercise. Touch your this roof with your tongue. And you can see the anterior or former part is hard, which is called hard palate. Now just touch your tongue slightly backward and that posterior part is soft. So that posterior part is known as soft palate. So on basis of this, these are differentiated into hard palate and soft palate. Hard palate is anterior part of the palate and is made up of maxilla and palatine bone. On ventral surface of hard palate, as you can see here, these ridges are present and these are known as palatine rugae. And function of these rugae is to prevent slipping out of food during mastication, and these are well developed in carnivores. If we talk about soft palate, then it is posterior part of palate. Soft palate is posterior part, and from it the posterior outgrowth of soft palate hangs down in the form of finger like projection, which is known as uvula or velum palati. On dorsal side of uvula, one pair internal nasal pores are present, and function of this uvula is to cover the opening of internal nasal pores. That means our nasal pores opens inside near uvula, which are covered by uvula during ingestion of food. So food particle cannot move inside nasal chamber. And you can see here this one pair of lymph node known as palatine tonsils. These are present on posterior lateral surface of soft palate and are known as palatine tonsils or tonsils. This is one pair of lymph node. Now soft palate is situated in pharynx. This is pharynx region, and soft palate is situated into pharynx region and is divided into two parts. This upper part is nasopharynx and lower part is oropharynx. Upper nasopharynx is related to nasal chamber and oropharynx is related to oral cavity. And one pair of eustachian tube, as you can see here, these are eustachian tube, is present in nasopharynx and it is related to middle ear. That means middle ear opens into nasopharynx with the help of this eustachian tube and it maintains air pressure. Now the oral cavity opens into pharynx, and pharynx is common opening for two tubes. One is esophagus and one is trachea. This esophagus is food pipe and trachea is wind pipe, and both tubes open into pharynx. And the opening of trachea, that is wind pipe, is glottis, and this glottis is covered by a flap, a cartilaginous flap, which is epiglottis. That means so you can say that trachea is covered by epiglottis, or opening of trachea, which is glottis, is covered by epiglottis during swallowing of food. So friends, today we discussed about basic components of food, about basic structure of alimentary canal, part of buccopharyngeal chamber, oral cavity, and in oral cavity we discussed about palate. And in our next video, we will start with tongue and teeth of oral cavity. So So if you are new to my channel, then do like, share and subscribe so that you do not miss any of my updates. Thank you.